Yes, dear students, in the last class we have studied the thermodynamics of ideal solution, in which we have studied what is the free energy change of mixing, what is change in volume of mixing, and what is change in enthalpy of mixing. All these things we have studied in the last class. Today the next topic we are going to discuss is thermodynamics of real solutions. Real solution is nothing but non-ideal solution. For example, when we draw a graph by taking vapor pressure in the y-axis and mole fraction, that is composition, in the x-axis, okay? See, the dotted lines are Rolle's law lines. See, this is, for example, I am taking a mixture of cyclohexane and carbon tetrachloride. Okay. See, that their vapor pressures are slightly deviated. The vapor pressure of cyclohexane is having a small positive deviation. Similarly, in the case of carbon tetrachloride, but the total vapor pressure line, the total vapor pressure of this type of solution lies within the vapor pressures of constituent cyclohexane and carbon tetrachloride. So it shows a small positive deviation. Okay, this is type 1. Another type 2, a solution shows, there are some pairs of solutions shows larger positive deviation. For example, type 2, large positive deviation. See, in this case we get a vapor pressure curves like this. When vapor pressure is plotted against the mole fraction, okay, this is Rolle's law lines, this is total vapor pressure according to Rolle's law, but I am getting the total vapor pressure curve like this, and vapor pressure of another constituent, the vapor pressure of another constituent
is like this.
See, here in this case, the vapor, that is, the total vapor pressure found to be maximum. It lies well above the vapor pressures of the two constituents. Not only that, the vapor pressure curves of each and every constituent shows a positive deviation. See, the deviation is positive. Usually, the solutions which are having weaker unlike interaction than like interaction, that is, unlike interactions are weaker than like interactions. Unlike interaction means the interaction between A and B is weaker than A and A. In that case, what happens? See, when the unlike interactions are weaker, usually such type of binary solutions behaves deviation from ideal behavior in a very large positive manner. For example, here, when acetaldehyde and carbon disulfide mix together to form an ideal solution, we get a this type of curve. There are so many examples for this type of real solutions which shows larger positive deviation. For example, water and propyl alcohol or propanol. Examples. These are all examples. And ethanol and chloroform, acetaldehyde and carbon disulfide. These type of mixtures, okay, shows larger positive deviation. Then we have type 3. Next type. In type 3, we have large negative deviation. What is the large negative deviation in this case? We get a curves like this, vapor pressure curves. See, vapor pressure plotted against mole fraction. Okay? See, this is dotted lines are Raoult's law lines. This is total vapor pressure, Raoult's law line. But for example, acetone and chloroform forms this type of real solution mixture with a large negative deviation. Here, what happens? The total vapor pressure shows a minimum. There is a dip in the total vapor pressure. The total vapor pressure lies well below the vapor pressure of both the constituents. Similarly, the vapor pressure of acetone also shows negative deviation. The vapor pressure of chloroform shows a negative deviation. Why this type of picture shows negative deviation? Because unlike interactions are stronger, unlike interactions are stronger. What is meant by unlike interactions are stronger? For example, AB interaction between unlike molecules are stronger than AARBB. Okay? In this case, it shows larger negative deviation. Larger negative deviation means the change in volume of mixing will be negative. The enthalpy of mixing will be negative. In the case will have delta V mixing will be equal to greater than 0. Delta H mixing will be equal to greater than 0 for positive deviation. For negative deviation, it will be less than 0. See, less than 0 shows that negative deviation, greater than 0 shows that positive deviations. Now, the next topic, very important 10 mark question. Next we are going to study the vapor pressure composition and boiling point composition of an ideal binary solution. See, next topic. Vapor pressure composition and boiling point composition curves of binary miscible liquids. Now let us consider a binary solution made up of two constituents, constituent A and constituent B. They are completely miscible with each other. When such a solution is miscible with each other, this is called a miscible liquid patch. On heating, what happens? Okay, on heating, the boil at a particular temperature at which their total vapor pressure will become equal to atmospheric pressure, then it is called boiling point. See, when a binary mixture is heated, when the total vapor pressure of a solution will become equal to the atmospheric pressure, then only the liquid starts to boil. That is called the boiling point of a solution. See here, the total vapor pressure of a binary mixture will be equal to the partial pressure exerted by constituent A and partial pressure exerted by constituent B. So, this P is called total vapor pressure. The total vapor pressure at which the vapor pressure of both the mixture will become equal, then it is called boiling point. So, the total vapor pressure of the binary mixture is equal to the partial vapor pressure of constituent A and partial vapor pressure of constituent B. See, solution of different compositions will have different vapor pressures. And in terms, when they have different vapor pressures, they will have different boiling points. Therefore, it is very easy for us to draw the curves of vapor pressure composition curves from boiling point composition curves and vice versa. Because the liquid which is having very high vapor pressure will have low boiling point. Okay? And those liquid which has very low vapor pressure will have high boiling point. So therefore, vapor pressure curves and boiling point composition curves are exactly opposite to each other. So from the vapor pressure composition curves, it is very easy to draw the boiling point composition curves because the vapor pressure and boiling point are inversely related. Greater the vapor pressure, lesser the boiling point. Lesser the vapor pressure, greater will be the boiling point. Now, we are going to draw. There are three different types of solutions. We are going to draw the vapor pressure curves and boiling point composition curves. First, number one. Type 1. In which the vapor pressure changes टॉप पोजिशन है. That is, see, when temperature is constant, vapor pressure, okay, this is composition, more fraction of A and B, mole fraction is 0 and A. When we draw the vapor pressure curve, see, A, B, this is liquid, this is vapor. See, from this we can draw the boiling point composition curve. Here, pressure is constant, boiling point, composition, A, B, C. This is vapor and this is liquid. See, this is type 1 in which the vapor pressure changes with the composition. Now let us see the first diagram in which A and B, A has low vapor pressure, therefore it has high boiling point. Okay? See, B is having very high vapor pressure, having low boiling point. So, here in the case of vapor pressure composition, okay, in the case of vapor pressure composition, the liquid phase will be in the top. That means in these vapors, the vapor will be rich in B because it has high vapor pressure. Okay, the vapors, among the these vapors of A and B, when we collect the vapors of a liquid pair A and B, then the vapor will be rich in B and liquid will be rich in A. Okay, so therefore, see, from the vapor pressure curve, we can draw the boiling point curve. Okay, so A is having very low vapor pressure, having very high boiling point. B is having very high vapor pressure, having low boiling point. This is type 1. In the type 2, vapor pressure curve shows maximum. See, temperature constant, vapor pressure, composition, okay, C, A and B. See, from this we can draw boiling point composition curve. Pressure constant, boiling point, composition. Okay, composition. I can draw like this. A, B,
this is C. So here, this is liquid, this is vapor. This is vapor, this is liquid.
In the tank 2, the vapor pressure curve shows maximum. See, here in this case, the vapor pressure of component A is less, whereas it has high boiling point. When these together mix together at a particular composition C, the vapor pressure will be maximum. In this composition, a liquid of having composition C will have maximum vapor pressure. The same composition liquid will have a minimum boiling point because it has high vapor pressure. Okay? So therefore, see here in this case, this type of liquid pads will show a maximum in the vapor pressure curve. Okay? And in the type 3, we have in tank 3 vapor pressure curve shows minimum vapor pressure curve shows minimum. See how
this is A and B, this is C. Here, liquid, vapor. Here, vapor.
Citizen, type 3, vapor pressure curve in which it shows minimum. That means, in this case, liquid A is having low vapor pressure, having high boiling point. Liquid B is having high vapor pressure, having low boiling point. See, in this case, in these liquid pads, at a particular composition, the liquid pad at a particular composition shows minimum vapor pressure. At the same composition, it will have maximum boiling point. So, this type of sometimes some binary mixtures will show this type of curves. So, these are all three different types of boiling point composition and vapor pressure composition curves of binary liquid pads. So, therefore, vapor pressure and boiling point are inversely related with each other. Therefore, it is very easy for us to draw the boiling point composition curves from the corresponding vapor pressure composition curve. So therefore, today we have studied the vapor pressures of real solutions. There are three types of real solutions we have studied: the real solution pairs with small positive deviation, with a large positive deviation, and with a large negative deviations. And apart from this, we have studied very important question, that is the vapor pressure composition curves and boiling point composition curves of binary liquid systems. Okay? The remaining topic we will study in the next class.